আসসালামু আলাইকুম অ্যান্ড ভেরি গুড ইভিনিং। যুক্তরাজ্য সহ পৃথিবীর যে যেখানে বসে এনটিভি ইউরোপের রেগুলার প্রোগ্রাম কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্স দেখছেন, আপনাদের সবাইকে শুভেচ্ছা সহ স্বাগতম বরাবরের মতো। আজকে আপনাদের সাথে আছি আমি আদনান পাভেল। আপনারা যারা রেগুলারলি কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্স দেখেন, আপনারা জানেন কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্স আপনাদের অনুষ্ঠান, আপনাদের নিয়ে অনুষ্ঠান। আমরা সবসময় চেষ্টা করি এই অনুষ্ঠানে এমন সব টপিকে কথা বলতে যা কিনা ব্রিটিশ বাংলাদেশি কমিউনিটি বা বাংলাদেশি কমিউনিটির উপর প্রভাব ফেলছে বা অদূর ভবিষ্যতে প্রভাব ফেলতে পারে। আজও তার ব্যতিক্রম নয়। আজকে আমরা কথা বলবো গত সপ্তাহে জিসিসি এবং এ লেভেলের যে রেজাল্ট দিল তা নিয়ে আজকে আমরা কথা বলবো। এবং এই টপিকে কথা বলার জন্য আমাদের সাথে আজকে এনটিভি ইউরোপের লন্ডন স্টুডিওতে জুম ভিডিও কলের মাধ্যমে জয়েন করেছেন একজন সিনিয়র একাডেমিক, অলসো দ্য সেম টাইম জিসিসি এবং এ লেভেলে ভালো রেজাল্ট করেছে, এরকম অনেক স্টুডেন্টরা আমাদের সাথে জয়েন করেছে। তা আজকে আমরা তাদের অভিজ্ঞতার কথা শুনবো, তাদের এই ভালো রেজাল্টের পিছনে কার অবদান ছিল, তাদের ফিউচার প্ল্যান কি, এবং যারা ভালো রেজাল্ট করতে পারেনি বাট দে ওয়ার্ক রিয়েলি হার্ড তাদের জন্য কি অ্যাডভাইস, তারা যেন তাদের মোটিভেশনটা তারা যেন ভেঙে না পড়ে, তারা যেন ফিউচারে তারা যেন তাদের হার্ডওয়ার্ক সেটা কন্টিনিউ রাখে, সেই ব্যাপারেও আজকে আমরা কথা বলবো। আপনারা পৃথিবীর যে যেই প্রান্তেই থাকেন না কেন, আপনারা কিন্তু সোশ্যাল মিডিয়ার মাধ্যমে আমাদের ফেসবুকের মাধ্যমে এই অনুষ্ঠান দেখতে পাচ্ছেন এবং আমাদের ওয়েবসাইটের মাধ্যমেও আপনারা এই অনুষ্ঠানটা দেখতে পাচ্ছেন। আর যুক্তরাজ্যে যারা আছেন তারা তো অবশ্যই টিভি সেটের সামনে স্কাই 700-তে এই অনুষ্ঠান দেখতে পাচ্ছেন। আপনাদের যদি কোনো অভিমত থাকে, কোনো প্রশ্ন থাকে, কোনো কনসার্ন থাকে, স্ক্রিনের নিচে যে ফোন নাম্বার আছে সেই ফোন নাম্বারে আপনারা আমাদের সাথে কল করে কথা বলতে পারবেন। তাছাড়াও আমাদের যে ইমেল অ্যাড্রেস আছে সেই ইমেল অ্যাড্রেসে আপনাদের মতামত আমাদের কাছে জানাতে পারবেন। তো আমি উইদাউট এনি ফার্দার ডু আমি পরিচয় করে দিই আমার সাথে আজকে যে প্যানেলিস্ট আছে, যে গেস্ট আছে তাদের সাথে পরিচয় করে দিই। আমার সাথে প্রথমে আছে সিনিয়র একাডেমিক মিস্টার আহসানুল আবেদিন, হি ইজ এ ভেরি সিনিয়র একাডেমিক। মিস্টার আহসানুল আবেদিন, থ্যাংক ইউ সো ভেরি মাচ ফর জয়নিং আস টুডে।
থ্যাংক ইউ ফর ইনভাইটিং মি এন্ড লেট মি ফার্স্ট কনগ্রাচুলেট অল দ্য স্টুডেন্টস হু আর ইন ফ্রন্ট অফ মি ফর ইওর আউটস্ট্যান্ডিং অ্যাচিভমেন্ট। হোয়াটএভার দ্য হিস্ট্রি অফ হাউ ইউ গট ইওর কোয়ালিফিকেশন, নো দ্যাট এন্ড দ্য বেস্ট থিং ইজ কনগ্রাচুলেশনস ফর ইওর আউটস্ট্যান্ডিং অ্যাচিভমেন্ট।
Thank you so much. We also have Yusuf Reza Khan with us. We have Hassan Al Mahmood with us. We also have Azmal Deen Kabir. We have Ishita Rahman. We have Anisha Rahman. We have Zabed Hussain. We have Saida Kamali. And last but not least, Tahmina Hussain. Thank you all of you for joining us today via Zoom video call. We are trying to make best use of technology during this unprecedented time of coronavirus pandemic. So thank you so much once again and congratulations to all of you for your brilliant result. We will hear your story and also at the same time your advice and recommendation for fellow peers like all of you. সুপ্রিয় দর্শক, ওয়ান্স এগেন আপনাদের যদি কোনো প্রশ্ন থাকে, কনসার্ন থাকে, আপনারা কিন্তু সোশ্যাল মিডিয়াতে কমেন্ট করতে পারবেন। আমরা উইল ট্রাই টু অ্যাড্রেস দোজ কনসার্ন, দোজ কোয়েশনস এজ ওয়েল। উইদাউট এনি ফার্দার ডু, ইফ আই কাম টু ইউ মিস্টার আহসানুল আবেদিন, ইফ ইউ ক্যান কাইন্ডলি টেল মি দ্যাট ইনিশিয়ালি দেয়ার ওয়াজ সাম সর্ট অফ confusion about A level result, particularly we have seen government's U-turn on the result, we have seen education secretary making public statements, students and teachers they were not initially happy the way the entire situation was dealt with. We know that government faces number of challenges including the Brexit negotiation, the coronavirus pandemic crisis, economic turmoil and many other issues. However, we have seen little bit of turmoil in dealing with A level result as well. A senior academic like you, did you or your colleague faced any sort of challenges dealing with this particular matter?
Thank you for that question, Adam. Let me open the statement with that on the 20th of March, all of you students got the sad news that the college or the school that you're going to closed because of COVID. And since then, that we've had this so-called information where we were told to inform you that your GCSE or A-level results are going to be postponed for this year, and we're going to estimate your grades, and also we're going to moderate your grades to give a predicted outcome. Now, one of the biggest turmoils that this has generated when the results came out on last week on the 13th of August was that the so-called algorithm or calculation that they used penalized it a lot of students across the country, not just BME or students, but students from different, from sadly to say, poorer neighborhoods were influenced and impacted. And as a result, we're in this situation. But the, regardless of who to blame on this, what I would have to acknowledge is the government reluctantly accepted and changed the rules and now accepted what the teachers have predicted for you guys. So therefore, you've achieved the grades that you should deserve. And that's the positive of this. Let's try to focus on the positives of this day, because rather than focusing on the negatives. But what I would say is there's a lot of achievement, a lot of challenges we will still face and you will face in the coming days, and especially in the future, because like most, all of you already know probably that you'll be called the 2020 batch. The A-level students who passed in 2020. But what it, one of the biggest challenges will be to overcome that and achieve outstanding from now on.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. Thank you. As you mentioned that instead of focusing on all the, you know, all the negative aspect, not being so pessimistic, rather we need to be very optimistic. We need to look forward and we need to deal with the situation. We have Yusuf Reza Khan with us, who has recently completed his GCSE with a very good result. Yusuf, if you can kindly share your experience, how you achieved such good result, who was the main inspiration behind it, what was the role of your parents or your teachers, and what you aim to achieve in near future. Mr. Yusuf Reza Khan, who has recently completed his GCSE with flying color, very good result. Yusuf, congratulations. Share your experience with me and my audience, please.
Thank you very much. I would like to say that it was not an easy journey after I heard that the school has been closed down with the uncertainty of grades. Talking about the algorithm and the government U-turns just before the results were coming out, especially as some people I know did their A-levels this year and were predicted very good results before the lockdown, but were sadly disappointed when the day came. But I achieved what I was predicted. I was very happy about that. And I cannot say how much I owe to my teachers
what
and my parents.
Sorry to interrupt. What was your result, if you can remind me and my audience, please? What did you achieve in your GCSE?
I achieved 7 9s, 3 8s, and 1 7.
Very good. Excellent. Excellent. So you said that the journey was a little bit difficult because of the ongoing situation. But how did you manage that?
With support from parents at home and support from teachers, I stayed in contact via email. It helped to manage the stress. And before lockdown, just working hard throughout to get good results in my mock exams. And just being there, my parents as well.
Very good, excellent. Very good. So,
made me believe that I would do right. Like, amazing.
Very good, excellent. So, you mentioned that staying in contact with your teachers, getting support from your parents, and also at the same time your own personal experience. Thank you so very much. We do need to go for a quick break for Maghrib Azan, so do bear with me. I haven't spoken to many of you, but I promise I'll be giving a floor to all of you to share your experience after the Maghrib prayer break. Shupriya Darshak, aajke community matters e amra kotha bolchi GCSE ebong A level er result niye. Amader sathe aajke ekjon senior academic join koreche, pashapashi GCSE ebong A level e jara bhalo result koreche tara amader sathe join koreche to share their experience and what we can learn from them, particularly considering the current difficulties, challenges they faced because of the ongoing coronavirus pandemic, also at the same time because of many other ongoing issues in the UK. However, they managed to achieve very good result. Tader sathe jara oneke kintu hard work koreche, but unfortunately many of their friends, they were unable to achieve very good result. However, eta kintu bhenge porar kono karon nei. They need to have that positive mentality, they need to be very optimistic and they need to look forward to the future. Amra Maghribir Ajaner Birotite Jabo, Maghribir Ajaner Birotir Por, তাদের সাথে আবারও আমাদের কথা হবে আপনারা যে যেখানে থাকুন প্লিজ কিপ ওয়াচিং এনটিভি সুপ্রিয় দর্শক বিরতির পর আপনাদের সবাইকে আবারও আমন্ত্রণ কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্সে আজকে আমরা কথা বলছি জিসিসি এবং এ লেভেলের রেজাল্টের উপর এবং এই ব্যাপারে কথা বলার জন্য আমাদের সাথে এনটিভি ইউরোপের লন্ডন স্টুডিওতে জুম ভিডিও কলের মাধ্যমে জয়েন করেছে একজন সিনিয়র একাডেমিক পাশাপাশি জিসিসি এবং এ লেভেলে যারা ভালো রেজাল্ট করেছে তারা আমাদের সাথে জয়েন করেছে এবং তারা তাদের অভিজ্ঞতার কথা শেয়ার করছে যে এই যে তারা ভালো রেজাল্ট করেছে তাদের এটার পিছনে ইন্সপিরেশন কারা ছিল টিচার বাবা মাদের অবদান কি তাদের ফিউচার প্ল্যান কি এবং যারা অনেক হার্ডওয়ার্ক করেছে বাট আনফর্চুনেটলি ভালো রেজাল্ট করতে পারেনি তাদের জন্য তাদের কি অ্যাডভাইস থাকবে কি রেকমেন্ডেশন থাকবে তা নিয়ে আজকে আমরা কথা বলছি আপনারা পৃথিবীর যে যে প্রান্তে থাকেন না কেন আপনারা কিন্তু আমাদের সোশ্যাল মিডিয়ার মাধ্যমে ফেসবুকের মাধ্যমে অনুষ্ঠান দেখতে পাচ্ছেন পাশাপাশি আমাদের ওয়েবসাইটের মাধ্যমে কিন্তু এই অনুষ্ঠান দেখতে পাচ্ছেন আর যুক্তরাজ্যে যারা আছেন তারা তো অবশ্যই টিভি সেটের সামনে স্কাই 780-তে আমাদের অনুষ্ঠান দেখতে পাচ্ছেন আপনাদের যদি কোনো অভিমত থাকে কোনো ওপিনিয়ন থাকে কোনো কনসার্ন থাকে আমাদেরকে কল করতে পারবেন বা আমাদের সোশ্যাল মিডিয়াতে কমেন্ট করতে পারবেন আমরা সেগুলো আপনাদের সেই প্রশ্নগুলো সেই কনসার্নগুলো অ্যাড্রেস করার চেষ্টা করব পাশাপাশি আমাদের যে ইমেল অ্যাড্রেস আছে তাতেও কিন্তু আপনারা লিখতে পারবেন তো আমি উইদাউট এনি ফার্দার ডু আমি আমার গেস্টদের কাছে চলে যাব আমরা আগের সেগমেন্টে কথা বলছিলাম মিস্টার আহসানুল আবেদিনের সাথে কথা হচ্ছিল আমাদের এবং আমাদের সাথে কথা হচ্ছিল ইউসুফ রেজা খানের সাথে কথা হচ্ছিল যে কিনা রিসেন্টলি তার জিসিসি কমপ্লিট করেছে উইথ ভেরি গুড রেজাল্ট সে তার অভিজ্ঞতার কথা শেয়ার করছিল এবং সে তিনটা জিনিস কিন্তু হাইলাইট করেছে নাম্বার ওয়ান ডিউরিং দিস ডিফিকাল্ট টাইম হি ম্যানেজ টু কিপ ইন কন্ট্যাক্ট উইথ হিজ টিচার্স ভায়া ইমেল নাম্বার ওয়ান নাম্বার টু হচ্ছে কনস্ট্যান্ট বাবা মার কাছ থেকে সাপোর্ট পেয়েছে থ্রি হচ্ছে তার ভিতরে একটা কনফিডেন্স সবসময় কাজ করেছে যে লুক আই ক্যান ওভারকাম দিস ডিফিকাল্ট সিচুয়েশন অ্যান্ড আই ক্যান অ্যাচিভ ভেরি গুড রেজাল্ট তো আমরা বাকিদের কথা শুনবো আমাদের সাথে এখন আরও যারা জয়েন করেছে আমরা তাদের কাছ থেকে শুনবো যে তাদের অভিজ্ঞতাটা কী হোয়াট হ্যাপেন টু দ্যাম হাউ দে ম্যানেজ টু গেট সাচ গুড রেজাল্ট হু ওয়াজ দ্য ইন্সপিরেশন বিহাইন্ড ইট অ্যান্ড হোয়াট ইজ দেয়ার ফিউচার প্ল্যান তো আমি প্রথমেই যদি সাদিয়া কামালি ইফ আই আস্ক ইউ দ্য সেম কোয়েশ্চেন during the we know that we are going through a very difficult time during this difficult time how did you manage to get such a good result who was the main inspiration behind it and what is your future plan sadia kamali who has achieved very good result in her a level sadia if you can kindly share your result with me and my audience what was your result sadia
so in total I got 4 A stars
very good
I think to answer your previous question, how did I get through it? Well, for me, it was the support system I had around me. my parents are extremely supportive and they understand that obviously doing your A-levels is a very stressful thing to do, especially in the middle of a pandemic, you know, to be sitting exams at home as well. And, you know, it's the way that they were there for me to make sure that I wasn't stressing myself out too much. Or even before the whole pandemic happening, when it was my application to university, you know, the way they, you know, gave me everything I needed to make sure that I could go to where I wanted to, that I really appreciate. And I think that's really what's got me here today.
Absolutely. Thank you. Thank you so much. So what is your future plan? What do you want to become in near future? What is your career plan?
So I'm going to study law at university. So hopefully that means I will be either a solicitor or a barrister in the future. And the goal is one day to be a judge if possible.
Very good. Very good. Excellent. Excellent. Congratulations for your excellent result. And we wish you all the best for your future career plan. And we also hope you get the right university so that you can fulfill your caliber and your aspiration. And congratulations to your parents and your teacher as well for your excellent result. As you mentioned that it is a teamwork, the support you had around you was amazing. That actually helped you to get such a good result. So congratulations once again. If I come to Tahmina Hussain, who also achieved very good result in her A level, if you can, Tahmina, if you can kindly share your experience with me and my audience that how during this difficult time, how did you manage to get such good result? And who was the main inspiration behind it? And what is your future career plan? Tahmina.
Hi. So I got A star, X star A. And I'm
Tahmina, sorry to interrupt. If you can kindly share your result with me and my audience, please.
So I received A star, A star A at A level. And I'm going to the University of Oxford. this October to study history and politics.
So international politics?
History and politics, yeah.
History and politics. Which university are you going to?
Oxford.
Oxford, very good. Congratulations. Very good. And I think this is the right university to study such a very good subject.
Yeah, I'm really excited for
very
it.
Good. Very good. Very good. So, Tamina, who was the main inspiration behind such a good result?
I think definitely for me it was my mum. So, I, like loads of children in Tower Hamlets, grew up in child poverty. So, I'm one of like the 58% people in this borough that live below the poverty line. And for me, it was just always my mum throughout my GCSEs, throughout my A-levels.
Very good.
For the past 2 years, who would do everything to make sure I had what I needed to do as well as I could. So, she would save up to buy me a desk, which I didn't have until I did my GCSEs. I did my work on my bed, on my table. And I think also just like friends as well. So surrounding yourself with the kind of people that make you want to do as good as you can for yourself.
Absolutely. So, absolutely. How about your teachers? How about your teachers?
So I think teachers as well, definitely. So like Yusuf, I also kept in touch with my teachers during the lockdown. I think it was really helpful just to have their reassurance and know that their support was still there, even if I couldn't see them face to face.
I see. Very good. You decided to study history and international relation, if I'm correct, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Why did you choose that subject? What was the main reason behind it? Why history and international relation? There are many other subjects. Why not law or become a doctor and other profession?
I think for me, it was just
By the way, having said that, the subject that you choose is very good, is excellent. It's really good, but I'm just curious, why did you choose such a good subject? What was the main reason behind it?
So for me, I think a lot of it was just really loving my subject, but also in year 12, I decided to look a lot at Bangladeshi history because I feel like the diaspora, and it's really hard to understand your culture. A lot of people don't really look at it. So I spent a lot of time looking at the 1971 war, looking at Sheikh Mujibur, and speaking to Bonga, so speaking to freedom fighters about their own experiences in the war and their perceptions of it. And it made me think, I really want to do this for the rest of my life. And I thought, it's a degree that also can equip me for my future ambitions as well. So I would really like to enter politics and civil service and this community. I thought that was a degree that would really help me understand how politics works in UK and back home in Bangladesh.
Very good. Excellent. It is so good to know that even studying in this country, even after going to Oxford, after getting chance in Oxford, after going to Oxford, after studying such a very good subject, you also decided to keep in touch with your root, which is Bangladesh. So this is very inspiring for me, and I'm sure for many of my audiences as well. Thank you so much for sharing your experience, and congratulations for your result. We wish you good luck for your future endeavor, and congratulations to your parents, and also at the same time your teachers and people, those who actually inspired you as well. You mentioned about your friends. So I think right friends are very important to achieve whatever you want to achieve in your life. We have Zabed Hussain with us, who has recently completed his A-level with very good result. It is mentionable that Zabed has a very strong immigrant background as well. His parents there, they came to UK very recently, but Zabed Hussain, he managed to get very good result. Zabed Hussain, if you can kindly share your experience, your journey with us. If you start with your result, and who were the main inspirations behind such good result, and even during this difficult time, how did you manage to get such good result, and what is your future plan, Zabed Hussain?
So I got A star in AA, and my inspiration was my parents, my friends, and my teachers.
Very diplomatic answer. So you covered friends, parents, your teacher, everyone. Very diplomatic answer. So what do you aim to study? International relation or politics?
No, I'm studying biomedical science.
Okay, I see. Very good. Excellent. Yeah. Very good. So, congratulations for your excellent result. You mentioned about your inspiration, and you have decided to study biochemistry, right?
Biomedical science.
Excellent. Yeah. Have you already secured a place at university?
Yeah, I'm going to Queen Mary University.
Very good. One of the top universities anywhere in the world. Very good. So, Why did you choose biomedical science? Is it because of this coronavirus pandemic or because of other difficulties we may face in near future?
No, so initially I had a dream to become a doctor, but due to some problem, I couldn't be applied to medicine. So I'm taking biomedical science so I can, I have another chance so I can have a try in medical science.
Very good, very good. I mean, biomedical science is another very, very excellent branch of medical science as well. So I think you made the right choice. The university is very good. You did a very good result. And you also mentioned very strong support system around you. So I am sure your future looks very bright.
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Zabed, another thing I mentioned when I introduced you, that you also have a very strong immigrant root. If I'm correct, do correct me if I'm incorrect. If I'm correct, your parents, they moved to UK very recently. So did that help you somehow give you very positive motivation that, look, my parents, they have worked so hard, they moved to this country, you know, leaving Bangladesh behind miles away, I'm in a foreign land, I have to do very well. Did that actually inspire you to go further?
Yes, that does always, as I always think about my parents, that how their hard work to come here and bring me such a country so I can studied well. I came here in 2017 in July, and I had to do my GCSE, and then after A level, it was a big jump for me. But that time, even when we come at the and we was new, my parents didn't hesitate me to put some, even to spend money on me for my study, because I was behind of my age like other students. So they put me a tuition center called Excel Tutor, and they put me there, and they helped me throughout my GCSE. And
very
then
good.
When I passed my GCSE, I went to a A-level college, Sixth Form College, which is very reputed in our council, which is London Academy of Excellence, Tottenham. And then I also was doing tuition in, taking tuition in the same Excel Tutor Center, because I need some extra support because I was very new that time, and A-level is very such a big jump. And
thank you.
I think my teachers helped me a lot, even in school, in Excel Tutor, and everywhere.
Thank you. Thank you so very much, Javed. I am sure, like you, tuition center, there are many other tuition centers, not just in London, but all across the UK that is giving extra support to the students, those who really want to achieve very good results. So it's not just your tuition center. I'm sure there are many others in London and all around the all around UK. The important point that you mentioned, that although you came back 2017, you managed to get in a very good school because your parents, they were always extra cautious. They were always very, very proactive when it comes to you. So, you know, congratulations to them. And it says a lot about their dedication and hard work as a parents for you. And I'm sure you will, in near future, as a son, as a responsible adult, you will do your responsibility as a son as well. So, Zabed, thank you so very much once again. We wish you all the best. আমাদের একটা ফোন কল আছে, আমরা একটা ফোন কল নিয়ে নিব। কলার আসসালামু আলাইকুম, আপনার পরিচয় দিয়ে আপনার প্রশ্নটি করুন। কলার আসসালামু আলাইকুম। ওকে, থ্যাংক ইউ, থ্যাংক ইউ। আমাদের, আপনাদের যদি কোনো প্রশ্ন থাকে, কোনো অভিমত থাকে, আমাদের স্ক্রিনের নিচে যেই ফোন নাম্বার আছে সেই ফোন নাম্বারে আপনারা কল করতে পারবেন, বা আপনারা কিন্তু ইমেলও করতে পারবেন আপনাদের যদি কোনো মতামত থাকে। থ্যাংক ইউ সো ভেরি মাচ। আমরা নাও উইল মুভ টু অ্যানাদার এক্সেলেন্ট স্টুডেন্ট, হিজ নেম ইজ আজমল দিন কবির। He has done very good. He has done excellent in his A-level result. Azmuddin Kabir, if I ask you the same question, if you can kindly share your result with us, and if you can kindly say how you managed to get such a good result during this difficult time, during this unprecedentedly difficult time of coronavirus pandemic, what was the main inspiration behind such good result, and what is your future plan? Azmuddin Kabir.
Yes. Hello, everyone. My name is Azmuddin Kabir. And I think to answer your question, it was very similar to Jabed's. So my parents, my friends, and my teachers who inspired me throughout my education. For my A-levels, I achieved straight A's. And next year, I'll be studying.
Excellent.
I'll be studying at UCL.
UCL. Oh, what subject you'll be studying?
So I'll be studying a subject called information management.
Oh, very good. Very good. Why information management? Why information management?
Computer science.
Very good. Why this particular subject? Why information management?
Because if you look at right now how the world is going, data, big data is very important in the private sector.
Absolutely.
Like, I'm very career focused, so trying to, like, I wanted to do a subject which helps me understand the big data and the and the programming, all these skills mixed with business, so I can apply it.
I see. So you are very career driven. You are very career driven, and you think this is the right subject for you, considering the global world. How data is an asset. How data is an asset. How everything is evolving around data. Why UCL?
I think that the private sector right now is like pioneering everything. Like, it's pioneering all the research right we have right now. It's always through the private sector, and it's always being financed through the private sector.
Absolutely.
So my ambition has always been to be a part of that. So that's why. One day I hope to become a management consultant, so then I can, you know, get into the business world and the corporate world.
Absolutely, very good. But why UCL? UCL a very good institution to study such subject? Why UCL?
Yeah, UCL. I chose UCL because of the global name. Last year they were ranked 7 in the world, and this year I think it's still top 10.
I see.
In the world. So it's the global recognition. So with that degree, I plan to move to other countries and work. I don't want to just stay here. I want to go move to America, Singapore, different countries where work is, where the best.
Excellent. Very good. So the global ranking 10 in the UK. You want to go to other countries as well. Thank you so very much for sharing your experience. Congratulations to you.
I'd like to say one more thing. My parents, like, they helped me a lot, and I feel like
absolutely.
To any students who are listening, to any parents who are listening, actually, it's really important to, as Jabed mentioned, to help the student go through tuition. So I also went to the same tuition as Jabed.
Absolutely, absolutely. Thank you so much. Thank you, Din. Thank you for sharing your experience, and wish you all the best for your global career plan. Thank you so much. আমাদের অনেক ফোন কল ওয়েট করছে আমরা একটা ফোন কল নিয়ে নিব কলার আসসালামু আলাইকুম আপনার পরিচয় দিয়ে আপনার প্রশ্নটি করুন কলার আসসালামু আলাইকুম কলার শুনতে পাচ্ছেন আসসালামু আলাইকুম কলার আসসালামু আলাইকুম আপনার পরিচয় দিয়ে আপনার প্রশ্নটি করুন থ্যাংক ইউ ভেরি মাচ আমরা মনে হয় আপনাকে মিস করেছি আপনি প্লিজ ডু কল আস ব্যাক উইল ট্রাই টু অ্যাড্রেস ইউর কনসার্ন উইল ট্রাই টু আনসার ইউর কোশ্চেন আমরা থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ দিন ওয়ান্স এগেন নাও ইটস টাইম টু টক টু সাম অফ দ্য জিসিসি স্টুডেন্ট ইশিতা রহমান
হ্যালো
ইশিতা থ্যাংক ইউ সো মাচ ফর জয়নিং আস টুডে উই নিড টু গো ফর এ কুইক ব্রেক After that, I will come and I'll listen to your experience. Thank you so much for joining us today. Shupriya Darshak, আজকে community matters এ আমরা কথা বলছি GCC এবং A-level result এই particular topic এ এবং আমাদের সাথে একজন senior academic এবং অনেক ভালো ভালো স্টুডেন্টরা জয়েন করেছে যারা রিসেন্টলি খুব ভালো রেজাল্ট অ্যাচিভ করেছে আমরা তাদের এক্সপিরিয়েন্সের কথা শুনছি এবং যারা এই অনুষ্ঠান দেখছে প্যারেন্টস যারা টিচার যারা বা যারা ফিউচারে এরকম ভালো রেজাল্ট করতে চায় তাদের জন্য কি ইন্সপিরেশন কি রেকমেন্ডেশন তা নিয়ে আমরা কথা বলছি আমরা যাবো একটা বিরতিতে আমাদের সাথেই থাকবেন সুপ্রিয় দর্শক বিরতির পর আপনাদের সবাইকে আবারও আমন্ত্রণ কমিউনিটি ম্যাটার্সে আজকে আমরা কথা বলছি জিসিএসসি এবং এ লেভেল রেজাল্ট নিয়ে রেজাল্ট অ্যানালাইসিস করছি পাশাপাশি আমাদের সাথে একজন সিনিয়র একাডেমিক জয়েন করেছে এবং স্টুডেন্ট যারা খুব ভালো রেজাল্ট করেছে তারা তাদের অভিজ্ঞতা তাদের ক্যারিয়ার প্ল্যান তাদের ফিউচার প্ল্যান তা কিন্তু তারা আজকে আমাদের সাথে শেয়ার করছে এবং যারা আজকে এই টিভি সেটের সামনে বা সোশ্যাল মিডিয়ার মাধ্যমে বা ওয়েবসাইটের মাধ্যমে যারা আপনারা এই অনুষ্ঠান দেখছেন যারা বাচ্চারা যারা ভালো রেজাল্ট করতে পারেনি কিন্তু অনেক পরিশ্রম করেছে তারা যেন মোটিভেশন না হারিয়ে যায় তারা যেন দে ক্যান কন্টিনিউ ওয়ার্কিং হার্ড উই উড এক্সপেক্ট দ্যাম টু কন্টিনিউ ওয়ার্ক হার্ড অ্যান্ড ইনশাল্লাহ ইন নিয়ার ফিউচার দে উইল ডু ভেরি ওয়েল শুধু টপ ইউনিভার্সিটি পড়তে পারলেই কিন্তু কেরিয়ারে ভালো করতে পারে তা না যদি যে কোনো একটা ইউনিভার্সিটিতে যদি পড়ে ভালো রেজাল্ট যদি করতে পারে হার্ডওয়ার্ক যদি করে তাহলে কিন্তু ফিউচারে তাদের ভালো করার সম্ভাবনা অনেক বেশি এবং শুধু ভালো স্টুডেন্ট হলেই হবে না ভালো মানুষ হওয়া কিন্তু ভেরি ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট সততা নিষ্ঠা ডিসেন্সি ইন্টিগ্রিটি অনেস্টি দিজ আর ভেরি ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট অ্যাজ ওয়েল সো আপনাদের যদি কোনো প্রশ্ন থাকে কোনো অভিমত থাকে এই অনুষ্ঠান নিয়ে আপনারা স্ক্রিনের নিচে যেই নাম্বার আছে সেই নাম্বারে কল করতে পারবেন আমাদের ইমেল অ্যাড্রেসে আপনারা যোগাযোগ করতে পারবেন অ্যাজ অলওয়েজ উই অলওয়েজ এনকারেজ উই অলওয়েজ অ্যাপ্রিসিয়েট ইউর কনস্ট্রাকটিভ ফিডব্যাক আমার সাথে যারা জয়েন করেছে আমি তাদের কাছে চলে যাব উইদাউট এনি ফার্দার ডু আমি প্রথমে আমাকে একটু আমি একটু কারেক্ট করে নিচ্ছি আমি আপনারা যারা প্রথম থেকে এই অনুষ্ঠানে জয়েন করেছেন আপনারা তাহমিনা চৌধুরীর অভিজ্ঞতার কথা শুনছিলেন সে খুব ডিপ্লোম্যাটিকভাবে বলছিল তার এই সাকসেসের পিছনে তার বাবা মা তার টিচার তার বন্ধুবান্ধব সবার অবদান আছে এবং সে বলছিল যে এই কারেন্ট আনপ্রেসিডেন্টেড ডিফিকাল্ট টাইমেও কিন্তু সে ভালো রেজাল্ট করার জন্য যা যা করা দরকার সেটা ভালো পড়ালেখার পাশাপাশি টিচারদের সাথে সবসময় যোগাযোগ রাখা ওনাদের রেকমেন্ডেশন নেওয়া ওনাদের অ্যাডভাইস শোনা পাশাপাশি হলো যে বন্ধুবান্ধবের সাথেও যোগাযোগ রাখা তারা কী করছে ভালো কী করছে সেইগুলো যেন সে নিজেও অ্যাডপ্ট করতে পারে সে কিন্তু তার কথা সে তার অভিজ্ঞতার কথা সে শেয়ার করছিল এবং মোস্ট ইম্পর্টেন্টলি সে একটা জিনিস বলছিল সে যুক্তরাজ্য থাকলেও এইখানে এসে বর্ন অ্যান্ড ব্রট আপ এইখানে সে পড়ালেখা করছে শি উইল গো টু অক্সফোর্ড টু স্টাডি হিস্ট্রি অ্যান্ড ইন্টারন্যাশনাল রিলেশন হাউ এভার শি হ্যাজন ফরগট অ্যাবাউট বাংলাদেশ শি স্টিল রিমেম্বার অল দোজ ভেরি ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট হিস্ট্রিক্যাল ইভেন্ট অ্যাবাউট বাংলাদেশ অ্যান্ড আফটার হার ডিগ্রি শি ওয়ান্টস টু ওয়ার্ক অন বাংলাদেশ শি ওয়ান্টস টু ডু সামথিং হুইচ ক্যান ভেরি ইজিলি ব্রিজ দ্য গ্যাপ বিটুইন ইউকে অ্যান্ড বাংলাদেশ তো তাহমিনা চৌধুরীর কথা আমি শুনছিলাম আমি বারবার তাহমিনা হোসেন বলছিলাম তার নাম হচ্ছে তাহমিনা চৌধুরী তাহমিনা চৌধুরী থ্যাংক ইউ সো ভেরি মাচ ওয়ান্স এগেন অ্যান্ড থ্যাংক ইউ অল অফ ইউ ফর জয়নিং আস টুডে অ্যান্ড শেয়ারিং ইউর এক্সপিরিয়েন্স শেয়ারিং ইউর ফিউচার ক্যারিয়ার প্ল্যান we have listened to many of the A level achievers. Now we'll listen to some of the GCC achievers as well. Straight away I'll come to Ishita Rahman. Ishita Rahman, if you can kindly share your experience with us and what is your future plan? Who was the main inspiration behind your such a great result? What is your result again, if you can kindly share with me and my audience?
So for my results, alhamdulillah, I got 4.8, 3.7 and 3.6. The people that mainly inspired me and helped me to get the best grades I could possibly get were mainly my mum and my dad. My mum and my dad made sure I got extra classes. I got home tutored by my uncle to help my grade for maths to improve. And they made sure they put me into a tuition, which was Excel tutors. And also my aunt also inspired me as she has always gone, she's gone through the career path that I'm wishing to go through, which is medicine, and now she's a doctor, so that's the main path that I'm trying to go through as well.
Right, very good, very good. So what is your future plan? So you mentioned about the contribution of your parents, the strong support scheme provided yes. by them around you, and even they provided you extra tuition. You mentioned about that.
Yes.
But what is your future career plan? What do you want to become in future?
So far, I want to, for my A-levels, I'm taking biology, chemistry and sociology. Mm-hmm. So I am hoping to go to uni and study dentistry or medicine.
I see. Very good. Very good. As Zabed mentioned that it is very difficult to go to medicine. So let's say, for example, in near future, if you even after doing a great result on your A-level, if you do not manage to go to one of the top university to study medicine, will you be, will you be demotivated? What would be your, your opinion? What would be in near future? I'm asking you a hypothetical question. If you do not get that place that you are expecting, what would be your reaction? Ishita, can you hear me? Ishita, can you hear me? Ishita. Sorry, I think we have lost Ishita. We'll try to reconnect with her. If I request Hassan Al Mahmood, who has done very well in his GCC result. Hassan, if you can share your experience.
I'm really grateful that I've done really well in my GCSEs. Mm-hmm. prior to the pandemic, I've been studying really hard to take my exams, and I was really concerned when the lockdown happened, but thankfully, I had support from my parents, from my teachers, and from a tuition center, Brighton Tuition, that I used to attend prior to the pandemic. Mm-hmm. I'm really happy with the grades I've got, and these grades have allowed me to get into a really prestigious sixth form, Brampton sixth form. Mm-hmm. And not only is this a great achievement for me, for my parents, for my family, but also for the Bangladeshi community, because I believe that we're ambassadors of the Bangladeshi community.
Absolutely.
Here in London.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. Absolutely. Hassan, thank you so very much for sharing your experience, and I'm sure, like your tuition center, there are many other tuition center in London and all across the UK, those who are actually supporting students if they need to. Hassan, what is your future plan?
Well, I'm hoping to study maths, further maths, chemistry and physics. Mm-hmm.
And so what do you want to become in near future?
Hopefully a form of mechanical engineer.
Mm-hmm. Mechanical engineer. Why mechanical engineering?
Partially because it's a big part of the human production, and as we're progressing into the future, we'll become more technological.
Absolutely.
And engineering is a big job in the world. So if I can get into mechanical engineering, I can become like a big landmark in Bangladesh society and London society.
Absolutely. Absolutely. Hassan, thank you so very much for sharing your experience. And although you are a very, very young chap, you mentioned something very, very important. That is, we are ambassador of our community. So if we behave nicely, if we behave decently, if we achieve very well in our career or our academic sector, that is actually an achievement for our entire community. Thank you so very much. Ishita, I think we managed to get hold of you. Ishita, you said that you want to study medicine in university. I asked you a very hypothetical question that, let's say, for example, in worst case scenario, if you do not manage to get to one of the top universities to study medicine, will you be demotivated? What would be your reaction? I know this is a very hypothetical question, but what would be your reaction?
Obviously, I will be disappointed because I do want to go into one of the top universities, but it won't stop me from wanting to continue doing medicine or dentistry because I've always wanted to follow that career path.
Right. Thank you. Thank you very much. So I assume this is very, very sensible for you, and we wish you good luck.
Yes.
Congratulations for your good result. Congratulations to your parents and your teachers. And we, like me, I'm sure all of us will expect that the support system you had around you will continue, and you'll keep doing very well in your A-level, and you'll go one of the top university to study medicine, and you'll become a very good, proud doctor of NHS. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Yes. We also have Anisha Rahman, who has done very well in her GCSE result recently. Anisha, if I ask you the same question, that what was your experience of dealing with this difficult time? How did you manage to get such a good result? And what would be your future plan, Anisha Rahman?
So I think I'm one of the students who could have done better, because I think most students like me thought that mocks wouldn't really be important, like the real GCSEs. Mm-hmm. So I was thinking about pushing harder in the real GCSEs, but unfortunately, because of the COVID-19, my mocks were used as the real GCSEs. So I'm still grateful for the results I got, which was 5.7s and 1.6 and 2.5s.
Very good.
I did pass all my GCSEs. As I said, I could have done better, and I did go to the same tuition, which was Excel Tutors, and I was progressing a lot and was hoping to do even better in the real GCSEs, but unfortunately, because of the COVID-19, I think that kind of held me back. Mm-hmm. The subjects which I'm hoping to do in sixth form are chemistry, biology, and psychology. Mm-hmm. And
what a great combination. What a great combination. So what do you want to become in near future?
Something along with clinical psychology.
Very good, very good. This is a very demanding subject. Psychology is a very demanding subject. Clinical psychology, considering the current world, it is a very demanding subject. So, why you choose this particular subject, clinical psychology?
So, I think that mental health is a growing disease in our world right now.
Mm-hmm.
And it comes from various different pathways. Mm-hmm. As technology grows bigger and society keeps on changing, I think the need for psychological advice for people and the clinical health is very important when it comes to mental health. And I've always been interested in, like, you know, people's minds and how things
absolutely
work.
Absolutely. Thank you very much. And I think mental health is a very, very growing concern, particularly for ethnic minority. We do not hear too much about it. I think this is a taboo subject. Still, this is a taboo subject in our community. It is a very, very important subject for young people, for ethnic minority, and I think you have chosen the right subject. So, congratulations for your excellent result. Congratulations to your parents and everyone, those who are involved with you know, with this entire process, and you are very lucky to have that you know, supporting system around you, and we would expect that the supporting system will continue so that you can excel, you can do very well in your A level, and you can go to one of the top universities to study clinical psychology. So Tamina, Anisha, if I'm correct, Anisha Roman, thank you so very much once again. Congratulations. Thank you. Now, it's time to come back to our senior academic who has been waiting very passionately after his opening remark. Sir, thank you so very much. My apology for keeping you wait for such a long time. Obviously, the education sector, you know, you and your colleague, you play a very critical role for their development. But what parents can do, number one, what definitely all of them, they are very well supported by their parents, they are very well supported by the surroundings, atmosphere they have. But what else parents can do, number one, and people, those who are not, young people, those who are unable to, young people, those who are unable to achieve the result they were aiming for, what would be your advice to them? Mr. Asanul Abedin.
Thank you for that question. Let me first acknowledge all of the future talents that are in front of me.
Mm-hmm.
We have counselor, a future projected judge, a powerful politician.
Powerful politician, yes, absolutely.
An engineer, a scientist, and
clinical psychiatric, yeah.
And a scientist, and
doctor, mechanical engineer.
If not, dentist.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so it's a proud opportunity to have a chat with you guys at the same time. Now, let's address the first question that you asked about parents, what we can do. One of the things during lockdown, what most of my team had problems was trying to communicate with parents and finding out if their child was struggling coping with COVID. So I understand that most of the students that we're having in front of this panel were most self-motivated themselves.
Mm-hmm.
So the challenges we faced, most of the challenges that we faced were founding when the parents weren't engaged with the students.
Mm-hmm.
So one of the things I request all parents to do is talk to your child. One of the things about the COVID situation is because of lockdown, your child has been away from his or her friends, from social interaction. So therefore they bottled up so much things in the last 6 months, we don't know.
Mm-hmm.
That will have impact on them re-engaging education in hopefully in 2 weeks' time.
Absolutely.
Which pathway? So again, we need to have a frank, parents need to have a frank conversation with the discussion of what needs. A lot of the students mentioned about tuition centers and support. Kids nowadays, yes, all of the kids today, or young adults, let me apologize.
Thank you.
Adults were brave enough to ask your parent for support.
Thank you very much. Thank you. We are running out of time. People, yes. Those who were young people, those who were working really hard, they were unable to achieve what they were aiming for. What would be your recommendation in 5 seconds?
My recommendation straight away would be to first talk to the head of school of their school and find out whether the school is doing a general appeal for them on their behalf.
Mm-hmm.
Number one. If not, if the school is like some schools, who've said that they're happy with the grades that they issued, they're not going to challenge it.
Yeah.
That students are, you have the opportunity to resit the exam this coming November.
Mm-hmm.
Small fee, but I believe the government is in the process of waiving
Thank
that.
You.
Yeah, so it's completely free.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Asanul Abedin, and thank you all of you, the future doctor, future politician, future engineer, future mechanical engineer, future IT specialist, and all of you. Thank you so very much, future clinical psychologist, and all of you. On behalf of NTB, we wish you all the best, and we would expect that the support system will be there for you, and you will do very well. You will make all of us more proud in near future, as all of you mentioned that you are the ambassador of our community, and if you can do something for Bangladesh, if you can do something for UK, if you can bridge the gap between these two countries, that would be great. Thank you so very much. Congratulations once again. Congratulations to your teachers, your parents, and all of you. Thank you so very much for joining us today. Shubhpriyo Darshak, aske community matters e amra kotha bolchilam GCSE ebong A level result niye. আমাদের সাথে একজন একাডেমিক এবং যারা জিসিসি এবং এলেভেলে হায়ার অ্যাচিভার তারা আজকে আমাদের সাথে কথা বলছিল, তাদের অভিজ্ঞতা শেয়ার করছিল। আপনারা যে যেখানে থাকুন ভালো থাকুন, যারা ভালো রেজাল্ট করেছে কংগ্রেচুলেশন টু দ্যাম, দে আর প্যারেন্টস, দে আর টিচার্স, যারা ভালো রেজাল্ট করতে পারেনি ভেঙে পড়ার কিছু নাই, প্লিজ কন্টিনিউ ওয়ার্কিং হার্ড। শুধু ভালো স্টুডেন্ট হলেই হবে না, ভালো মানুষ হতেও হবে। ইন্টিগ্রিটি, অনেস্টি, সিনসিয়ারিটি, দিজ আর ভেরি ভেরি ইম্পর্টেন্ট, অ্যান্ড ইউ আর দ্য অ্যাম্বাসিডার অফ ইউর ফ্যামিলি, ইউ আর দ্য অ্যাম্বাসিডার অফ ইউর কমিউনিটি। সো do continue working hard. Apnara je jekhane thakun bhalo thakun, shusto thakun. Thank you and take care.